and hear my proposition when you're headed for some fun in the sun. And
jeez, I don't know how they let some of these videos on the web. I gotta bookmark this page because, you never know.
Hey, Rockfish, what are you doing?
Oh, checking out some, I'm working. What can I do for you, Alena?
Well, I was wondering, have you ever heard of something called barotrauma?
Barotrauma. Oh, sure, they're a great group. I didn't know you could pierce your skull like that.
No, Rockfish. It's a condition that happens when you're reeled to the surface by the fishermen. It's what happens when your swim bladder gas expands so much, so you're almost like a rockfish balloon at the surface.
Whoa.
It's when the gas fills you up that your eyes are popping out of your head and your stomach's coming out of your mouth.
Oh, my.
Well, let me show you a little video we have on this subject. I think you need to see this.
Ever wonder why a rockfish gets barotrauma? Rockfish have a small bag of gas inside them called a swim bladder, which helps control buoyancy. When a rockfish is captured and reeled to the surface by a fisherman, the gas in the swim bladder expands and escapes into the fish's body through small tears or ruptures. The built-up gas pressure forces the eyes to bulge, and the stomach is often pushed out of the fish's mouth.
Oh, that's a nice red. You can see that this fish is suffering from some barotrauma because his eyes are averted, popped out. He's not just surprised to see me.
I think I had that happen to me once, but I thought I'd eaten a bad sardine.
But I've already got my limit, so I'm gonna throw this one back.
If you throw this rockfish back into the ocean, it will just float away because the excess gas makes it too buoyant to swim back down on its own. Often, these floating rockfish are eaten by birds or other marine predators.
That guy looks like toast. I wonder if I can get his rock.
Okay, gang, wind up in here. We've got to get going. We're catching too many of the wrong kind of fish here.
The best thing to do is avoid catching rockfish that have to be thrown back. So if you are catching fish that you don't want or that aren't legal to catch, move on.
Yeah. That's great. But what about old Popeye over there?
Okay, guys, if you're catching too many of the wrong kinds of fish here, just tell the crew members and they'll use the deep water releases to let your fish go.
What is a deep water release?
A deep water release or recompression device is any device that helps a fish descend in water, preferably as close as possible to the depth it was captured. The research scientists in this video are lowering a rockfish with barotrauma back down to the depth that it was captured. As you can see, the excess gas inside the rockfish actually recompresses, allowing it to swim away. Their research has shown that even severely bloated fish can survive if released to deep water within 5 minutes, but the quicker the better.
All right, so I'm gonna release these using the milk crate method.
Try to handle the fish as little as possible when unhooking and placing in a release device. A fish's slime helps protect them from infection. The more you handle the fish, the more of the slime that comes off.
And there's some technique in keeping the fish in the milk crate so that they stay floating up in the upside down milk crate once it's in the water.
A weighted cage such as a milk crate may also offer rockfish a bit of protection from sea lions or a hungry lingcod on their way back down.
And then we'll let them down to depth. So I've actually counted out 40 handfuls at about 2 feet per pull. This is roughly 80 feet, and you see the line is tending to stay slack. It's way down there. And now the line is tight, so I'm gonna go ahead and pull the crate back up. And the fish are back home.
So, that seems okay if it's like shallow or not too windy, but that's not always the case.
When I fish deeper water, I like to use a Shelton fish descender to release fish.
Rockfish recompression.
Some fishermen use this device to release several fish at a time.
Now, in order for this to work, you need to hold the weight up in the air to keep the fish on the hook.
There we go.
Down he goes. And using the Shelton fish descender, it allows me to release my fish that I'd like to release and then continue to fish once I'm down on the bottom with the two baited hooks.
That's good. How about when everybody's puking their guts out because it's so rough?
There are several fish gripper devices available, but the weather, the size of the fish, and the bottom type will affect how well they work.
Hey, Rockfish Recompression!
This is a black tip catch and release device. It's one of several lip gripping devices that are available on the market. It works by opening the jaws and closing them over the lower jaw of the fish.
Then you simply put the fish over the side in the grippers and lower the fish down slowly. It's important that the weight hit the bottom solidly in order to get the jaws to open. It's also important to make sure that there's adequate tension to keep the jaws shut as the fish is descending.
Hey, Rockfish Recompression!
This is the Rockfish fish releasing device. The Rockfish is a good choice if your fish are from small to medium size.
You open the jaws, close it over the lower jaw of the fish, lower the fish over the side, and when you get to the desired depth to release the fish, you give a quick tug on the line, the jaws open, and the fish swims away.
Rockfish Recompression.
The Sequalizer can be set to release at any one of three pre-programmed depths. The jaws clip together like so, and at the programmed depth, it releases. The Sequalizer can be used on even larger fish.
Nice video. Not enough car chases for my taste, but it's a nice video. Hey, Elena, before you leave, do you want a sardine? They're imported from Cuba.
No, thanks. It's a little early in the day for me.
Nice to see you, kiddo. Now, where was I?
Hear my proposition. When you're headed for some fun in the sun and do some fishing, if you get protected species or you meet your rockfish quota, always be prepared if you
land them in your boat.
Angler party boat, and it's starting to rock. The genus is Sebastes, and we like it quite a lot. It means magnificence in language of the Greeks. Some cool fish of fluvia for ichthyo geeks. Yellow eye, vermilion, and canary are a few. Get to know your rockfish and what you should do. Have a rig and a plan how to get them to the bottom. Have a heart, do your part, and send them down to where you got them.
Like a rock, drop them back into the bottom. Send them back to the back, send them back to where you got them. Let it roll, let it roll, as they fade in their decision. Drop barrel trauma, drop a rockish recompression.
Hey, coming from the deep, the gaslighter expands. Got their stomach in their mouth, now the time is at hand. Exophthalmia abounds and the eyes are bugging too. Don't you go and poke them, cause that's just cool. Barbless hook, milk crate, don't be a fool. Commercial fish descender or a recompression tool. Got so many ways now to get the job done. It's really not a hassle, it can even be fun. Got to be quick, man, that ain't no jive. Time is of the essence for the fish to survive. Rockfish, paper, scissors, and we're in it to win. Rock it like a rockfish, sink and swim.
Like a rock, drop them back into the bottom. Send them back to the blast. Send them back to where you got them. Let it roll, as they fade in their decision. Drop the barrel, trauma, drama, rockfish recompression.
Like a rock,
drop them back into the bottom.
Send them back to the blast.
Send them back to where you got them.
Let it roll,
as they fade in their decision. Drop the barrel, trauma, drama, rockfish recompression.
Like a rock,
drop them back into the bottom.
Send them back to the blast.